They simply can't get into a running game with the Celtics, the Hawks. They've got to keep it slowed down as much as possible. Ainge, three-pointer. Bird, Wilkins trying to stay with him, get some help. Harris with the baby hook. Great move to the hoop, trying to reverse layup, and Bird was there to block it. Jump ball. Downfield and Bird.
Frank, Boston is playing with a lot more emotion today than they did the other night. They are really into this ball game. Johnny Davis with a strong drive here on the baseline. Didn't get it to go down. Bird with a piece of it. And then when the ball went out of bounds, Bird and Roundfield tied up and they called a jump ball.
Celtics as a team shot only 40%. Benny Johnson out with injury. Larry Bird answering for the Celtics. Dominique Wilkins behind the back pass and a beauty. The Davis hits. Forced that shot. Tiny Archibald. Great pass down to Bird. 2 points. Working on their second comeback of this ball game. Wilkins having trouble controlling it. 3 seconds. Bird with a great save. With the miss, the follow is good by Maxwell. Take a look at that save of Larry Bird's a moment ago. It would have been an over and back violation otherwise.
It looks like the ball is just, no one's around. And all of a sudden, Larry Bird just hurls his body. You can see his foot is on the other side of the 10-second line. It's a great play. The Celtic fans now are chanting Larry.
Larry is the chant. Direct them at this man, Larry Bird. We said he was a bird of a rare kind that threw the ball to Bird in the corner. Got around his head. Macklin. 11. Three players in double figures for the Celtics who come up with a steal. Henderson to Bird, too. Tail. Wilkins. Maybe a little out of his range. How about the arch you put on that one?
That was a tough, tough shot. And Quinn Buckner laying on his back there. Tree Rollins is
66-47, Boston. First ball.
Danny, he's just punched Tree Rollins in the stomach off the screen that time. Tree not real happy.
Here to go on to beat Milwaukee. Rollins takes out the frustration on the basket. Here we go. Danny Ainge. Oh, a free-for-all. Officials all over the floor trying to pull him apart. It's still going on. We've got everybody on the floor involved. I thought they said the hockey game wasn't until tonight.
Well, Danny Ainge got the worst end. He's got Dan Roundfield and Tree Rollins on top of him right now. They can't get him off. Tree Rollins has got him in a headlock, but we saw that coming a while ago when Danny Ainge and Tree Rollins were getting into it. Well, you don't like to see this because, you know what, somebody get hurt in something like this and miss the playoffs. This is not a good scene at all.
Let's see how it started. It looked like Ainge tackled Rollins, but they're still taunting each other here. This may not be finished yet. Wilkins wants a piece of somebody. And the trainer, Joe O'Toole, pulling Wilkins back to the bench.
Frank, one thing I've always learned, never try to break up a guy fighting, especially big man. I did it 5 years ago with Daryl Dawkins. He punched me and split my eye open in the Portland series. If those big guys are going to go at it, you get out of the way because there's nothing you're going to do.
Ainge is leaving. Whether or not it's by injury or whether it's because he's been asked to leave remains to be seen.
I would be very surprised if Tree Rollins was not ejected along with Danny Ainge.
Well, Ainge looked like he tackled Collins. Let's take a look at it again. Here's how it started. The Roundfield flying down the floor. Then look at the elbow there on Ainge that was thrown by Tree Rollins. And now Ainge will tackle Rollins. Watch this.
Well, he was smart to go in low because Tree was going to throw a haymaker at him there. He had to get him down. Danny Ainge, baseball, basketball, looks like a nice open field tackle there also. Here's where you get hurt, though. Larry Bird, you see Larry Bird's shoulder like that?
Take a look at it, another angle. This is a pretty flagrant elbow he threw at Ainge.
He's retaliating for what happened a while ago. He just popped him right in the head. And Danny Ainge, a vicious competitor, as is Tree Rollins. Now, these are things that happen in playoffs. And, Frank, we talked about it the other day. The same thing happened In the Philly series last year, Tree Rollins and Lionel Hollins, Lionel broke his hand and ended up missing the majority of the playoffs. This is one thing you don't want to happen.
Watch the elbow. Watch Rollins' elbow right there, the left hand, right to the head of Ainge, and Ainge, infuriated, comes back and tackles him.
You know, as a smaller player, you've got to stand your ground against a big person.
The interesting thing is that Ainge has left the floor and Rollins is still out there.
I don't understand that at all.
Well, the officials, as they say so many times, you see the second shot.
Yeah, I just...
The retaliation.
Normally when two guys go, though, it takes two. And normally when two guys go at it like that, you've got to let them both go. So, but I'm not going to try to make a judgment on that. It's just amazing.
Kevin Lockery did everything he could to get his players out of there as you look at Bill Fitch. And we'll take a look at what Kevin did. Now watch Lockery as he gets into this thing and tries to pull his players out of there. There's Kevin on the right of his screen. Well, he's trying to pull McHale out of there right now. He got a hold of McHale's jersey, trying to get him out of there.
And Kevin's a fiery guy. You don't want to mess with him. He's got a temper, and he's going to fight to the end with his team.
Darrell Garrettson, who of course is the head of the NBA officials, and one of the officials explaining now what the ruling is to both of the coaches involved. Bill Fitch on the left and Kevin Lockery on the right. Now the first report we get is that Ainge and Mike Glenn have been ejected. Now Glenn did not figure, at least in the beginning of that.
I think what happened was that after they separated Ainge from Rollins, that he and Glenn got into it a little later on. I'm not really sure, but that's the only thing that could possibly have happened.
Well, Tree is still out there, so you'd have to think that they missed that the first shot, the elbow that he threw that really got Ainge infuriated.
I tell you, if anybody ever wants to say, is there any intensity in these playoffs, you can see it right now.
Okay. The voice that you may have heard in the background was Darrell Garrettson, who just leaned over to us and confirmed that Ainge and Glenn have been ejected. Again, another look at the replay, and watch Danny Ainge on this one. Ainge number 44, right center of your screen. He's waiting down court. He saw Rollins coming, didn't he?
I think it was just a situation where he was going to protect himself. He saw a Tree come flying at him.
Again, see the same thing. Ainge was not backing off.
They both have been going at it, and I said a while ago previously that Ainge had punched Tree in the stomach.
There's Glenn leaving now. So as Darrell Garrettson told us, Glenn is out, and Ainge has been ejected from the game. Buckner has three for Boston. Bird, three-pointer. You think he feels confident right now?
Well, Celtics are moving the ball, making that one extra pass and shooting wide open jump shots.
Johnny Davis puts a move on Henderson.
Bird
there again to reject him. Bird with the rebound. Great outlet. Down court to Parrish. Little 10-footer. Maxwell with the tip. Get into a tight situation. Bird wants the ball.
Well, he's such a relentless player. You know, he just never gives up. If he wants a rebound, he goes after it. That's an unbelievable shot.
Just your routine 20-foot fadeaway jumper. When he start the final period, 78-62 the score. We are checking between quarters on the injury report, and we've been informed that Danny Ainge has what has been described as a human bite on his right middle finger, which required 5 stitches. And it happened somewhere in that brawl a few moments ago, midway in the third period. I wonder what other kind of bite they would be talking about in contrast to a human bite. Bird saw McHale, and McHale is rejected by Rollins. 44-33. Davis drills one. Henderson. Again, Henderson. Back to Maxwell. McHale with the follow. Rollins underneath. That's it for him. Rollins fouls out. Rollins Celtics will not win any popularity contest here this afternoon because of that confrontation with Ainge.
Well, the first question, of course, is the condition of Danny Ainge, the bitten finger. Can he play? Will he be effective?
Well, right now, it's still, and we're right to game time. We're going to wait and see what type of protection we can put on it. And I still think it's doubtful, but he was much better this morning in shoot around. But it's based on what we can do for that finger, what we can do for the injury.
It has got to hamper his shooting incredibly.
Well, that's what I mean, what we can do for it. In other words, protect the injury and still have some type of touch. And all the kidding's over now. We've been kidding him, you know. Well, there's one thing, you can't hurt your shooting, Danny. But he's a very good shooter, and it does have an effect on it.
Okay, so Rocky Ainge may not be able to play in this ball game, and as you can see, the videotape showing the altercation between Ainge and Tree Rollins.
The teams are going to think they're looking in the mirror because they both play very similarly. They both.
Danny Ainge is starting.
Well, that's. I'll tell you what, I don't think the Celtics need an emotional lift tonight, but if they do, this certainly should provide it.
And they're giving him a standing O. Gerald Henderson raises his hand as if he is a championship boxer, and now he walks away from Ainge and leaves him there all by himself.
Oh, you mean guy.
I'll tell you, I admired Danny's courage the other night and Sunday afternoon in just taking off after Rollins and not taking his baloney. Many people, however, have questioned the wisdom of it all, being going after a 7-foot-1 guy. And actually, if it hadn't been for the foolishness of the finger biting, no one really would have been hurt out of the whole thing.
I know NBA centers have been known as big eaters, but I've never seen one try to eat a 6'5 guard before.
Boy,
that's incredible.
Danny, I know NBA centers have big appetites, but I've never seen one try to eat a 6'5 guard before.
Yeah, it surprised me. I was down in the file and helpless, and he started gnawing on my finger, and I didn't know what to do but scream. You know, I couldn't believe he was doing it.
Someone told me Rollins said something about BYU guys are kind of tough to chew, and he spit you back out or something.
Well, it felt like. I thought he was going to bite it off, to be honest with you. It hurt pretty bad.
Here's, let's take a peek. Maybe you can give us commentary on this. You're a fighter, too, evidently.
Well, I was my only choice was to tackle him. I thought he was going to come at me with some punches, and I didn't want to get into that situation with a 7'2 guy. I could barely jump high enough to get up and hit him in the head, so I had to tackle him. And
now, at this point, he doesn't have your finger, right?
No, right about, I guess right about now sometime. There he is. He's.
Gotcha, yeah.
He's.
Well, he's getting the salt and pepper out now. I can see that.
Yeah.
Don't you know you're not supposed to pick on those big centers? There's got to be some little water boys or someone you can go after.
Well, you know, I just felt that I had to defend myself, and that was the only way I could do it.
How do you feel about the commissioner's ruling, Dan?
Well, you know, I don't want to comment on Tree's situation, but my situation, I don't think it's fair because I felt that I did what any player would do and what I had to do, and I feel it was unfair to get fined $1,000.
You were just telling me that in shooting practice today, you think you were shooting better. Is that right?
Yeah, I was shooting a little bit better. I don't know why. Maybe I'm concentrating more or something. But I got the two fingers taped together, and we'll see how it goes tonight, I hope.
Super. So you expect to possibly play tonight?
Yeah, it's up to Coach to decide on how effective he thinks I can play. But as far as I'm concerned, I'm ready to go.
Okay. Well, Lanier's even tougher than Rollins, so leave those big centers alone, big guy.
Okay.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to be back in just a moment.